army under you. Let the devil know that you have the sword of the Spirit in your hand. Amen. And don't be ashamed of that sword. Because the same sword is laughing of demonic spirits. The same sword he goes to the heart. Amen. And he finds the soul from the Spirit. Amen. The same sword. Don't be ashamed of that sword you carry behind with you. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The book of St. Mark. Oh, thank you, Lord. Oh, bless all them sharing to come forward and testimonies. And truly, hallelujah, as the scripture says, as arrows in the hand of a mighty man, I see all arrows in the hand of a mighty man. Hallelujah, that's what I'm going to speak. Testimony that God is real. God can deliver. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The book of St. Mark. St. Mark chapter 4. Praise the Lord. It's a beautiful book. Amen. Hallelujah. Mark writing through the eyes to the visual, the apostle Peter, and he pen him down. And when Peter can look, then he writes him down.
Amen.
So the same Mark in Ezekiel 4 verse 7. Well known parable, we know the parable of the sower. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. But the book of St. Mark 4 7, you see there, and some fell among thorns. Can you say thorns?
Thorns.
Amen. And some fell among the thorns. Either so when we go by. Past the ground, they got the thorns. Gracious God that we serve. If the word well, it's still so well.
Oh,
where did it come from? The word of the Lord, it begins somewhere. Amen. So let me see, Lord, he talked. And the thorns grew up and choked it, and it yielded no fruit. We go down a few verses. Praise the Lord. Verse 18 and 19, we see there. And these are they which are sown among thorns, such as hear the word. 19, you see. And the cares of this world, and the deceitfulness of riches, and the lusts of other things entering in, choke the word, and it becometh unfruitful. Where God is having word, when God is meant to be fruitful. Man's wisdom, man's knowledge, he choked the word from being fruitful. Amen. Get ready, because God is showing me something. God is such a heart for youth here tonight. Yes, God is such a heart for youth. I've come across this clip. I seen a sheep overcome. And we come and we pass with one bramble. Bramble, everyone, thorny bush. Thorny bush, and we come and we pass. And we try, come out. And we can come out. So what does sheep we do? And when we stand up there, aim the fight. And we stand a great death when we come. And we stand a great death when we come. And go, and we'll be hungry. And we'll be thirsty. The person you speak, the sheep may be either die of the hunger worm or the thirst worm. Or may be die of the pneumonia may attract them. But because they be stuck with a bramble, they may not move. And when it's gonna steal, sheep will that kind of animal. When something in people are calling pass, all of them find their way out. Or they look for the easy way. I've asked the bishop to say a word of prayer. Bless me and give me strength to deliver His word of God. Amen. Hallelujah.
To
bless us.
Lord Jesus, we come, O God.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
And the power of the Lord has been spoken by Thy word. Lord, lay your hands upon the one that are about to release the chain that is caught upon the throne. May your word deliver us, O God, from the thorns. Anoint this man, O God, that he may speak the revelation and the mystery of how to deliver us from the thorns. Anoint him, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Anoint him, O Lord. Speak to him through the Holy Ghost tonight. We ask him, Lord, in the most splendor and powerful name, the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Glory.
We're living in a world today. It's a thorny world. The world is a thorny bushes every dark corner you turn. Even the elect of God, he can get caught up. Get stuck with this thorny mess of this world. This world is not an easy world. Money making this world hard. Money should get God into their mind. Because of man's way, man's wisdom, man's knowledge. Amen. Thank you, Lord. When a bishop be making an announcement for that rally, the same night you be making an announcement for this youth rally, Lord, give me this word. From that time, just ponder where the word come true. You know, you have to digest. What? You know, many other brothers night or sisters night, youth night, attended them one. But you don't listen to encouraging words, you can come out. That is a food that are faithful you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Me and Bishop, we got one brother's night, only me to be there. And then you share and encourage me about digesting the word of God. When you receive the word, not spewing and biting it. Receiving a word, let him settle into the heart of you. Meaning that time, when you get a word of God, no one time I do want to stand up. I just speak because I need a good one come. Need to receive a good God with his altar. Thank you for God. Slowly grow in grace as the word of God is speaking. Amen. Praise the Lord. Lord, I boast the Lord what a man can do. Amen. Hallelujah. See what a time you can do. I wouldn't think 10 years ago that I was down a youth pastor or youth for a church or living, but you know what? The same youth, I'd be down them. When I was in a religion, I'd be down with them youth for church or living, Lord. What did they ask for? What did God? Amen. But when it comes to the point where I meet that, Lord, he said for me, he asked for you to kick against the prick. I will kick against his sharpness of God. Amen. So I betray them. You know, when the word of God in me come out like the thorniness, he even just pierced me. Pierce me, man. Every release of my calling. Lord, he said for me, okay, you're down in the same youth. You come, youth pastor. And same youth. Apostle Paul, and I'm slowly around, and I'm persecuting the church, letting me like, okay, you're going to die in my church, let's keep my church, okay, you come here, you be apostle, but the same church, you be apostle, and the same church, amen, hallelujah, and there you go, we have New Testament written, amen, hallelujah, praise the Lord, okay, praise the Lord, so Lord, show me this one, thorns are choking, the growth of the word of God in you. So the heading, thorns and choking the growth of the word. Amen. Praise the Lord. No, I'm really blessed because I began a vision a few years ago. Again, this vision that I see myself. I cast a net, Yahweh, riverway with this fresh water. Cast a net, and I look, what's a wave he comes towards me. I look the way you come and I step back, come up to for the hill. He said, with a dream of me, the vision. Dreaming there, I look one nice, chubby, big youth. What about kind of thing? Big ice cream wear. And we look one seat. And we look one seat. So what did we do? The seat is down.
Come.
Look at ice cream wear, sit down.
All right.
Look at ice cream.
Richard.
The way here come. So look at ice cream. Ain't gonna take notice. Here I come out for the hill. But the same you can see now, look at ice cream go down to the water. A hippopotamus. Big hippopotamus it come out from the water. While in there eat the ice cream, ain't gonna take notice. The hippopotamus it come straight for him. Grab him, swell him, check him with effect. But the water, drag him with the water. Amen. Then youths, listen carefully. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. This world in a land that has plenty of hippopotamus around. Amen. They want to take you to a dark place and keep you trapped there. Amen. Hallelujah. If you be complacent when it's walk for you, if you be lazy when it's walk for you, let me out to get you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. But just so you get the picture, thorns, let me enemy choking the rope of the word of God in you.
Amen.
Amen. Go to the book of Proverbs. Proverbs 24. Written by a youth. Let me seek after the wisdom of God.
Amen.
In Proverbs 24. Proverbs 24, verse 13 and 31.
Amen.
He speak there, and lo, it was all grown over with thorns. Praise the Lord. 13, you see there, I went by the field of the slothful. Slothful mean lazy. Slackness. And by the vineyard of a man void of understanding.
Praise God.
We can come worship the Lord, but we're still void of understanding.
Amen.
We can come praise the Lord and we're still lazy.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I see many people in fall because of laziness. And laziness is creeping up now. I don't want to do anything for the Lord, but just swing your arm. You can swing your arm, Mr. Heaven.
No.
Amen. You have to fight any kind of faith. Take from the way. Come in the heaven. My question was that one. Amen. Praise the Lord. And he got down, you see there, lo, it was all grown over with thorns and nettles.
Yes.
Had covered the face thereof. That's 31. And the stone wall thereof was broken down. Okay. So this writer in this book of Proverbs, and we walk by a vineyard, and we look, you're all grown over with thorns and nettles. So what is that really telling me? And we mentioned about the slothful. See, the laziness, families, youths, when you are lazy in following the Lord, halfway you will get taken over with thorns.
Amen.
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 Hard to take over your thorns, you go start for choking a word for God now. Then you be once listening, you be hearing, you be asking, and you be trying for two. So when the word is just start to shoot up, it's very hard for you. The thorns are covering you. Maybe choke them. And you thank the Lord, maybe suffocate. The word of God being fruitful inside with you. Okay. Listen to this. When you know praise, when you know worship, guess what? Thorns.
Come on.
When you know find yourself inside the house of the Lord, guess what? Thorns. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So check yourself before you wreck yourself. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. No. The word of God, everyone, encourage us. Amen. Hallelujah. Take us and put us on a level that we can be fruitful. That we don't be barren. We have a knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So, thorns, every choking a growth for the word of God in you. So this young man, you go by and see what the laziness you do. Eat pretty obvious, son. Say you sit up in the house and then. You look them grassy, grow a yard, and then you just sit down. Say, I'm not going tomorrow. I'm not going next week. I'll wait when I got my mower back. And then you look grassy go grow. And then you go grow. Praise the Lord. See, the point is, when people are lazy, that thorn will come push. Suffocate the word of God for the heart. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Okay. Proverbs 21. Well on scripture.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And see, verse 1, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord, as the rivers of water, he turneth with whatsoever he will.
Amen.
The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. Lord is Sabbath. Heart with you.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. No heart in pillow or the thorns. Amen. Praise the Lord. Said righteousness everywhere, verse 2. Everywhere a man is right in his own eyes, you be made to come to mind. He right for mindset with you. Give us life with a beautiful team. Amen. Praise the Lord. So, the way of man is right in his own eyes. It may seem like he's all good in our mind. We find ourselves in the house of God. But our heart should be different from the mind. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Listen when the Proverbs speak. But the Lord pondereth the heart. Amen. You may come and think you're all good upstairs. Yes, come pray. You worship the Lord. But why are you praying to worship the Lord? You don't pray, you don't worship the Lord. Lordy. Ponder at the heart, baby. Think it to come inside. Amen. And Lord, man, what are these things that you do at our heart? Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. We need to check ourselves. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord before we go. Wreck ourselves. Amen. Thank you, Lord. The thorns, the different thorns, and be choking the word of God, and be suffocate the word of God. Amen. So anyway, a man is in right with his own eyes, but the Lord, and he ponder the heart.
Amen.
Amen. Hebrews 4:12. Amen. Is blessed tonight?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Oh, this God is so. He is an awesome God. He's a great God. Amen. A loving God. That's why He gives me a word that He stays forward.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. That's the truth.
Yes.
Amen. Now I come from a religion that He lied. That He been deceived by the prince of the power of this place. But I also love for the truth that he will step in.
Yes.
And I thank God that he persecute the church.
Oh, yeah.
Because that son is way for me. He said for the church.
Yeah.
Yeah. Praise the Lord. If you persecute this church, you can make it for me. You can make it for yourself. Praise the Lord. So to save yourself, praise the Lord. Just leave us alone. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. The book of Hebrews 4:12. You see that the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing into the dividing asunder of soul and spirit and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Amen. Amen. So the word for God, amen, it's amazing that if we allow the sower for sowing the word into our heart, no matter which ground we got, where our heart. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. The word of God, somehow we go penetrate. Amen. True. If you have stony heart, the word of God is a little bit, it will penetrate your heart. Amen. Hallelujah. If your heart is good, that's good. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If your heart, hallelujah, that is full of thorns, let your word get one. Go inside with your heart. Amen. Hallelujah. And penetrate. And will check out. What a rubber help you. And will give you the boost from within. You see a seed. When a seed, you plant a seed. And you don't shoot straight up. First thing that we do, our root will come out from them. Root when we come out, and we look up for moisture, and we go down pass.
Come on.
So the seed in, and the root, and we go down, 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 down. Look at that, and we start to get settled in now. Then once we settle in now, then we go start lift up now. Right now, let me choke in the word of God. Let me suffocate the word of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay. Come, you abide there for St. Mark.
Amen.
I will reveal for you part, or the word the Lord will reveal to you part. One of the same thorns as we've been reading that before. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. 19, speak then. And the cares of this world, thorn number one. Thorn number one, the cares of this world. And they care too much for the things of this world, and they choke at the word of God. Amen. That's the thorn, the cares of this world. Okay, cares, let me mean a serious attention or consideration applied to doing something correctly or to avoid damage or risk. So, in another words, can't you that time? You please the world more than you please God. Amen. Amen. When we please the world, more we choke in the word of God, then we want to be fruitful. Amen. Instead of a heart for me, instead of life for me. Because when the word of God is to be fruitful in our lives, in our heart, amen, we will present our bodies a living sacrifice. We will present your holiness. We will present your righteousness. We will present your godliness. Hallelujah. We will walk as a spirit image for God. Amen. Hallelujah. We will be ready to us. Amen. Praise the Lord. So those that be choking the word, the pump of the word is going to help you. Amen.
Amen.
So when I'm reading, I'm meeting with the same cares. Cares. And I'm right to them. I'm a master for writing on notes and them on. Praise the Lord. I like to just go as the Lord continue in my mind and just be. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. So focusing more to the things or to the world than the word.
Amen.
Amen. Never come to the hell so you can get into the word.
Amen.
Amen. Not the world. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
As we get into the dawn, verse 19. And the deceitfulness of riches, thorn number two. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thorn number two. You know, once I was a man that even got issue, even got trouble with gambling. Because it was a family jewel. My grandfather to my father, he became down for me. Praise the Lord. The wrong inheritance. Praise the Lord. But I thank God for the truth, for the word of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. So the point is that deceitfulness of riches, when I'm in Israel, for Israel, like, poke his area. People said one that one. Poke his area and I go. Put your money. Centrelink, $200. So that's how addictive I was to that screen that you'll be smiling in there, hoping that I'm going to get something. Well, pay off from that one. Like, God, so you waste the money there. The money when you said, heart is mass. Money when you said, heart is mass. But because I've been deceived by the deceitfulness of that riches. Deceitfulness, the action of keeping the truth hidden, especially to get an advantage. So see what the devil he do? And we put it that thorn, that deceitfulness of riches. And we put it there. We suffocate the word. That's some advantage for the enemy. When you get deceived, you say that deceitfulness, the delusion of being rich. Okay, can I say this? Sometimes we speak, oh, paramyakam, deceitfulness of riches.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. I stand for the truth and I love this truth.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Let's just be real for God. Let's not be a mimic. Amen. Let's walk in the footstep the Lord wants you to walk in. And be an example of the believers. Amen. So, riches, I mean, keeping you away from the word of God.
Yes.
Amen, hallelujah. You may come here tonight and listen to the word of God, but when you go, aside from this building, you'll find yourself being deceived. You'll find yourself for the cookies you don't bring you. Silent money inside. Pop. Hoping I don't have a dollar sign. We're hoping for something that is not true. Well, I know a God that he owns silver and gold and doesn't cattle on the hill. I know a God that is a creator of everything and he can supply all you need. Amen. Hallelujah. The same God that created everything. Amen. He is real. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay, we go down. The last big day is big. 19. And the last of other things, amen, the last of other things entering in. Last of other things entering in. You know, youth, we met that area. Our hormones are very high up there. We get lustful for things. We desire this car. We desire this job. I am lost for this girl there. I am lost for this boy there. Amen. Praise the Lord. Lost, any strong and powerful desire. Amen. You don't get deceived. No, lost, and we got no power there too. It's a thorn when we choke in the word of God. Amen. But let me choke it, the word of God. So last I'd be right with that you lust for things that you deeply crave. We can come like the scripture is seen. Everywhere a man is seen right in his own eyes with the Lord and we ponder the heart. Your mind may be at the right place, but your heart craves for something else. What is out there? Amen. And that thing he choked the word of God from being fruitful inside of you. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know that the sheep when we get caught up with a bramble, you know, either heading towards that one or to that one. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
But it's amazing, strong desire for other things instead of God's word. So three things Lord points them out. And them same things, three things, it trouble on youth nowadays. Amen. They are becoming thorns. See, when we become lazy, I mentioned it before, when we become lazy, or thorn pushes you start growing. Instead of a heart moving, then you will start choking the word for God. Then you will find yourself retaliate. You will ask for an eye business, tooth for a tooth business. See, evangelist can't see six up one, right? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. See, thorns are choking the ground of the word of God in you. So the word, everybody be fruitful, youths. That we're going to be fruitful in our hearts. Thank you. Thank you, Lord, because the enemy don't like this one. Satan don't like this one. I said, beside them, things come for distracting our mind, distracting our heart, that we will find ourselves doing other things. And then we will look the word of God one side. Some of us youth, we come into this building, God, he died a mind moving, they know your front. You know, everyone's different. I come, we're all good. Oh yeah, because my big father and we pastor that time. I come to church, oh yeah, please a man, please a God. My heart can be far away. That's when I come inside. When I stop louder through the praise and worship, go aside. Mind you, grab a long beach smoke, fire up there. Come inside again, you see the word? Then go inside again. Go scab now for another man's smoke. Somebody inside. That's how stupid I was. Amen, amen. Thank you, Lord. But I'm not ashamed of this song. I know where God is taking me from. Amen. Hallelujah. But like, he's taking me out of, and in a mighty flame, he set to my feet upon the King's highway. And he's taking me out of the darkness, and he's taking me out of this land, so I can praise him for the deliverance. Deliver me from being dead. If you can deliver me from being dead, that can deliver everyone in all of his secret dark spot, because it's God that we serve. And we see that I am the light of the world. Amen. Hallelujah. For the light, everyone has changed you. Step into darkness. Where the darkness did it come from? I want the light to be appear for you. Amen. Testify about that one. Speak about that one. Amen. Hallelujah. Because why? You don't have a thorn in you anymore. Amen. Praise the Lord. See, thorns, and we choke in the word of God. Deceitfulness of riches, and we choke in the word of God. Cares of this world, and we choke in the word of God. Amen. Lust of other things entering in, choke in the word of God. Amen. But there is a cure. But before I will get to the red part, St. Matthew.
Amen.
St. Matthew, run our scripture.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. St. Matthew speak them, 6 verse 33. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Instead, let the thorns that cares of this world be in your heart.
Amen.
Seek first the righteousness of God.
Amen.
Amen. The kingdom of God and his righteousness and all these things shall be added unto you. Amen. Hallelujah. So instead, having cares for this world in the spiritual walk for you, trade them in for seeking the Lord. Seeking the kingdom of God. Rally, come up. Go for rally. Conferences, come up. Go for conference. Most of all, tell me to come. Hallelujah. Turn the Bible to it. Go for it. Go to it. Amen. Because that's the place where you will find it. The husbandman, and you will start. Fuck out all the thorns. You're taking up. Praise the Lord. And you can become fruitful. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Matthew 19. I love this story, young
man.
So it's a beautiful story. Verse 21. Lord, you see, for this young rich ruler, become, seeking guidance, direction.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And see, Jesus said unto him, verse 21. If thou wilt be perfect, go and sell that thou hast and give to the poor, and thou shalt have treasure in heaven. Then there is again, come and follow me.
Amen.
Amen. You guys ready for this one? Amen. Thank you, Lord. All right. You know, sometimes we youths, we like to protect who we are, our reputation, we like to protect them.
Amen.
Or I'm the cool and popular guy at school.
Amen.
You hide them. You hide them. The word of God is around for you.
Amen.
Or even at your workplace. Or even in the shopping center. Or wherever you go, you hide them. You protect them. That reputation for you. You are about choking a word. Choking a word. Choking a word. Thorns. Choking a word. Choking a word. Let me suffocate the word. Amen. Praise the Lord. So this young rich ruler become. And we got everything. You name it. And we got house. And we got car. And we got aeroplane. And we got a coffee table. and they're catching friends and be doing good. And be holding to the commandments of the Old Testament, honor father and mother way, to all the things. But Lord, he said, okay, you got everything. What's selling the things, my friends? What's selling the things you got? Selling your reputation, selling your house, selling your car, selling everything in the common. Follow me. No, that empire, Lord, the same story. The young man, he turned around, the rich one turned around, heart is sorry. Sorrowful heart, he turned around and he go. And he rather the thorns, he choked it up, word of God.
Amen.
And if he sorrowful will happen, instead of selling things that he's so attracted to, you know, and be attached more to the riches than to God. Many of us, we attach more to our riches than the things of God. Amen. Oh, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Let me remind you, thorns you choke and broke with the word of God in you. Amen. So, it's amazing. We go to 2 Timothy 2:22. Then I'll come to a close.
Amen.
Truly God is good. Truly all the time. God is love.
Always.
Always.
God is love.
Thank you, Lord. Yes, He is a loving God. Because if we love the Lord so much, He gave His only begotten Son. And whosoever believes in Him will never perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen.
See, youths, everlasting life is just there.
Amen.
Get rid of the thorns.
Amen.
And you choke the word. The word of God, even from here, it is yourself only. The word of God, even created, is yourself. The word of God is in heavenly places. Heaven and earth will pass away, but the word will not pass away. Word will be everlasting.
Yes.
If we can allow this, man, if you just think, if we can allow this everlasting word of God, it will just be fruitful in our life. Will be. The song we sing, I want to hold to His hand. Hold to the word well. The word will take you to heaven.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. So in 2 Timothy 2:22 is written.
Amen.
Flee also youthful lusts, but follow righteousness, faith, charity, peace with them that call on the Lord out of a pure heart. Amen. Simple, and you see that Paul encouraged a young man, Timothy, a young bishop, encouraged him, flee the youthful lusts. Flee the cravings for this world. Flee all the things that are making you protect your reputation as a youth being the strongest guy or girl. Praise the Lord. Flee them on. But follow after righteousness. Faith. Them are things for God.
Amen.
When you follow after them one. See, some of us, we want to follow the Lord. Follow. But our heart get caught up with thorns. We suffocate the word of God. Paul encourage us, beautiful, for flee them, youthful lust. You know, when we sit down last night, amongst our bishop and evangelist chemist, and just listening to Sherry and Sherry, and Lord just revealed for me how tender their heart. And making me realize how tender their heart is. Making me wonder the same heart. And because the heart of me is so tender, you planted a word for God, even one time you will shoot. You know, nothing will trap them. Nothing is suffocated. Now, when our evangelist came to see you last night, when the latter rain and the former rain come, together. You know, we're the Old Testament time when they put an ox, or they put two ox together, or they put two experienced ox together. One experienced one, another one we're young, and we come to call the one and the walk. Amen. So we bless the Lord that what if you have a life for our elders? Amen. And it can be youth, I mean, it can be yoked with them as they teach us. We walk as we go. We walk by faith, not by sight. Amen. We ask the Lord that, Lord, if you preserve a life for our elders, that they are beautiful people that he come to serve the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. So we learn from every one of us. We can learn from our adversaries too.
Amen.
Because they're playing teaching me what not to do.
Right.
And truly God is good.
Yeah.
And truly all the time.
Yeah.
Amen. All right, I come to a close here. But my colons are choking the growth of the word of God.
Amen.
In you. So, the sheep. I'll talk about the sheep. The sheep may be walked by the fence line. We're going to find himself being trapped with the same bramble. Now, bramble, you may ever taste the raspberry, you may ever taste the blackberry. Is something where you come from? Or brambles?
Yeah.
The thorniness of the stem, whatever, it produces the goodness. So the sheep you become, and we pass the same bramble. And then, when you look at the same bramble, the thorn worm, even though stick straight up as the lemon, it point the opposite way of which way we grow. So when we attracted or praise worm, go inside, like you smooth on the inside, but when you come on sight, you go past, you're stuck. So the sheep, and we go by the same way, going to find themselves being stuck. And try come back out the same way, stuck. Try all kind. The sheep in me. I am that sheep that in the past were thorn. I received the Lord into my life 2010. 10 years ago. 11 years ago, I received the Lord.
Here we are.
Baptized in Jesus' name.
Yes, sir.
I remember this shirt that I began on in Leonard Psalms 23, verse 1 and 2. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. So how was that sheep that you baptized? Come out. Or we got rallied there, Marque. Come towards the end of 2010, I'm around the market, and I become, I be walked down here. I become, I be get caught up in the thorns, brambles to be young. My wool be stuck, I try to come out, see if it's not come out. No, I be finished, trapped in, so whatever you do, I be just wait. Wait for, like the sheep be dead, wait for death to come. So I've been the same sheep that it be passed. My wool be passed where the bramble, where the thorns for this world. That it be choking the word that I receive, I be trapped. So I be allowed the lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, the pride of life, deceitfulness of riches. I be allowed them to enter into my life and it be choking who I was for the Lord Jesus Christ. He be choking me, and I be choked for about 19, 18 months. The same brambly choking me. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And it come to the point where I sit down, I find myself, just sit down the road at Tibari Street, I sit down. Myself just thinking about life and everything else and the pressures that I've experienced that time. You know, I definitely person that I have a low self-esteem. I'm a shameful person. I always lie. You can ask my mom. I had a quiet one. I don't know everyone. All my gay men. Mind you, all my gay men, those small ones with me. I had a same one of them for everyone. They put my mouth out of God. I was a sheep, so they were about. Don't speak anything. Praise the Lord. So I'd be finding myself sitting there going on, thinking about stuff, and this totally become. Going down for the corner, and then you get a buffalo there. Going for the buffalo and get a cotton with you. Go for the corner shop, and then get a rope. That night, I was planning on taking my own life because I was feeling broken inside. The things that I've been doing, let me satisfy me. Feeling lonely all the time that I've been struggling with. My self-esteem is really low. Like, I think, oh Lord, how come I'm not that kind? Why are you not that kind? Like all my kids, all their brothers, like all the everything going for that one. So I've been thinking of things and that thought had come. The spirit of suicide had become. Doing this thing. But let me tell you, families, the thief cometh not, but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But when the same passage of scripture, the Lord is saying, but I come. When you're in a loneliness stage, but I come, Lord is telling us. When you're feeling down and broken, but I come. When things are going right for you, but I come. He said the God that is a good shepherd. A God that is a good shepherd. And we know the sheep were. I mean the sheep that we get stuck in the thicket. I was the sheep that we get stuck with the bramble with the thorns. That if you choke in me, that if you suffocate my growth, suffocate the word for God from going in me. I'd be suffocating. I'd find myself being trapped in the deceitfulness of this world. But the farmer become true. The shepherd become true. I'd be finding myself having another dream. In the dream, I find myself standing up straight here in the same hall. I stand up here, face this way, altar service. Bishop Rubini conduct the altar service. And I stand up here feeling all filthy, guilty, and I'm not worthy enough for the man of God for coming and lay a hand on top of me. Suddenly he saw it in a dream. A week after that one, I find myself standing up in this exact same spot, weep before the Lord. As the farmer become and become out here, the sheep from the bramble, the shepherd become. The shepherd won't come for me. The shepherd come. Emily, I'm not talking to me. What did we do? And be the shepherd that you become me. Come on, to the deceitfulness. Lord, in Israel. Come on, to all the balls that I've been running myself in, stuck in with his life.
Hallelujah.
The shepherd you become. Come on, to be pray on top of me. Let me tell you that there is a shepherd, the bishop of our souls. He knows your heart. And we know that there's thorns in your heart. But can you allow him tonight to step in and let him perform the work? Come to the thorns from your heart so that you can be fruitful fruitful in the knowledge of Him, so that you can follow after the things for Him. He's a God that He loves you. Maybe not slack concerning promises for Him. There is a shepherd, there is a farmer that He can come unto all the thorns that you have in your heart. Peter, he speaks under the Holy Ghost. Repent and be baptized. Every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins. For the remission of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Maybe you don't be baptized yet, and then you're still in that valley of decision. There is a God that, Lord, if you look the heart, maybe there's thorns in that heart. But you can worship with the water. As we seek, sanctify us through thy truth. Thy word is true. Every word of God is pure. The book of Acts, chapter 2, verse 38, is a pure word. And we can wash away the thorns inside of our heart with you. And can clean your heart. He knows our heart, my friend. Youth, He knows our heart. Every way of medicine, write your own eyes, but the Lord ponder the heart. God bless families.
Praise God, Heavenly. The Lord knows the heart, He knows exactly what we're giving us through. Exactly where we go, why we here, why we travel so far and near, why we come to the door even tonight. Maybe there's a thorn in the heart that there is unfaithfulness in you, but something. Maybe there's a, you can't say it, but the heart. You know, the heart speaketh. The word tells us, the Lord said, the heart speaketh. The heart will tell the Lord what's wrong. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We worship the Lord.